Natanggap na raw ng US government ang listahan ni Senator Laila de Lima ng mga nasa likod ng pagpapakulong sa kanya. Now, this is a updated list that includes some very prominent politicians and supporters of President Duterte. Mm. Richard, what do you think about this latest list? Tingin mo ba this will finally get the attention of the authorities?
So, una-una, may mga known unknowns dito, no? Hindi natin alam kung exactly the same ito dun sa initial list na minention ni Senator De Lima a few months ago. But there is some suggestions or reports that even President Duterte and some propagandists of the regime could be on the list, no? Ang second na hindi natin alam is how will this be received by the U.S. State Department? Mm-hmm. Kasi depende ito sa executive agencies of government, whether tanggap nila yung buong list and whether what kind of sanctions ang impose nila. Travel ban nga lang, or they're gonna add other kinds of sanctions. Kasi potentially under the Global Magnitsky Act, you can impose also financial sanctions, no? Against yung mga tao na involved in gross violation of human rights. Also, Atom, no? To be specific dun sa legal reference ng travel ban list ni Senator De Lima, ito ay base dun sa mga additional provisions na forward nila Senator Durbin and Leahy last year, no? Dun sa 2020 US national budget. Now, itong list na yan, this is not about necessarily the EJK cases in the Philippines or reports of human rights violations in general, but dun sa mga quote-unquote persecutors ni Senator De Lima. Mm-hmm. Now, Atom, of course, wag din natin kalimutan yung big picture. The big picture is nagde-deteriorate yung bilateral relations natin with the United States. May effort by the Philippine Senate and perhaps people within the government to still save the day, no? Pero kung ma-implement ito ng State Department, if other top officials in the Philippines, perhaps even President Duterte, face sanctions or ban, then I think we're really going to go for a full-blown crisis in our alliance and relationship with the United States. Ngayon, mm-hmm. other countries are also watching out kasi over the past few months, kinausap din ng office ni Senator De Lima, other Western nations, including officials and visitors from Australia. Now, mm-hmm. Australia, meron din silang status of forces agreement, which is very similar to VFA, and under the Global Magnitsky Act, they could also contemplate, no, imposing their own versions of sanctions against the Philippines. The European Union has also suggested that. So, ngayon, the thing is, this is not just about Senator De Lima, this mm-hmm. is not just about her persecutors, but really strategic relationships sa pagitan ng Pilipinas and a whole number of other countries.
Let me play devil's advocate for a bit. Hindi ba panghihimasok ang Global Magnitsky Act sa sovereignty ng isang country? Hindi ba ito pwedeng gamitan? Halimbawa, pag hindi gusto ng US yung mga namumuno, kumukontra sa kanila, patawan ng ganung klaseng sanctions.
So, Atom, no? So may Global Magnitsky Mechanism and Global Magnitsky Act. Yung mechanism na yan, hindi lang US involved, but multiple countries. Ang argumento dyan, Atom, is pagdating sa human rights, this is a universal value, no? Mm-hmm. So, hindi lang depende sa Philippine government yan. In fact, under the responsibility to protect principle. All of this, by the way, the Philippines has acceded to at the level of United Nations. May obligasyon ang isang bansa na protektahan yung kanilang citizens laban sa mga heinous crimes or gross human rights violation. So, the notion of national sovereignty ay limitado pagdating sa universal value of human rights, which we approved and accede to as member of the United Nations.